North Berwick. Fringe on the Sea.
Oh, there we go. Thank you.
My favourite festival in the world.
Is it really? Is it your
favourite? Well, my favourite festival in Scotland. Well, my favourite festival in East Scotland. Well, my favourite festival in North Berwick. Yes, it's good. It's excellent. No, it's great.
Fantastic. Just to let everybody know, we're sitting here with Chris Glenn from Cafe Jacques. We're going to go backwards in time.
Right.
As opposed to forward from the beginning.
Well, so, what did I do? I was born. Oh, no, you want to go right back. Well, first there was the dinosaurs, then the crustaceans period.
Very good.
And then we move up to now. No, I was with the Alex Harvey Band from the late 60s. Yeah. Right through, and then with various other people. I was with John Martin, Liam Gillen, various other people. This year, for instance, I was with the Michael Schenker group in the 1980s. I was with Michael Schenker earlier on this year, with the drummer from AC/DC, a chap called Chris Slade. And in fact, when did I play the Carling Academy in Glasgow last? 2 weeks ago, I played the Carling Academy in Glasgow with Michael Schenker. Last weekend, I was in St. 2 weeks. Yeah. 1 week ago, I was in St. Petersburg in Russia, playing at the Werewolves Motorcycle Club. It's the biggest motorcycle club in Russia. I was playing there with a band called Steel Circle, which is another 16 songs to learn. And then I flew back on Sunday, started rehearsing with this lot on Tuesday for tonight. And but this is the one I've been looking forward to.
Oh, definitely. Actually, funnily enough, I was talking to David earlier about me being here. This is the first time I've been up in this region, as well as my station manager pointed out very rightly. I've just spent my last Canadian dollar and I've lived here for 11 years. So I'm
we'll try and make it worth your while.
I appreciate that, Chris. Honestly. But really, I'm looking at the history of, as you just brought it through,
in 2 seconds, yeah.
Yeah, basically. It's true, but that's the best thing, to wrap it up in a nutshell. That's what it's all about.
Yeah.
The history of...
The other thing I haven't mentioned is, I'll say this very quickly, on the 2nd or 4th of September, I'm getting a Lifetime Achievement Award, the Alex Harvey Band are, from the Scottish Musician Society Award, somewhere in Glasgow, on the 4th. So I'm looking forward to that, because I've had a couple of Lifetime Achievement Awards with the Alex Harvey Band, but it's usually one award, which the manager keeps. You know, so I've told this guy, I'm not turning up unless I get an individual award for each of us. So I'm looking forward to that.
That's fantastic, Chris. I'm looking at also, well, tonight, when you're playing on stage, I've decided I have to stay now. I was going to go home and go.
In that case, I'll stay as well. I was going to go. I was going to come home with you.
We've had this discussion before we went live on air, but...
and you're not sitting on my knee. No, you're not sitting on my knee.
No, it's quite all right. Not to worry. Oh, this will be this is a pre-record for next show. This is not going out live tonight.
Oh, well, after the gig, who knows what can happen, you know?
We've only got the nurses outfit for one night.
Yeah, we've only hired the nurses outfit for one night.
Oh, is that what that's there for?
Yeah, that's what that hat with the cross on it is.
I've dealt with that one before.
Well, okay. Tell me about it. Right, I'll interview you now. You know,
feel free, Chris. Been around, done all the things.
Got a t-shirt to see, yeah.
Okay. Definitely got the t-shirt. And the ring to go with it.
I don't have one of them. Have you just showed me your ring?
No. That one will be...
Duncan's just shown me his ring.
I was told, Chris, that you were like this.
I'm not. I'm very good.
So what have you got lined up for tonight?
Tonight we're going to do a very strange, a different version of a song that the Alex Harvey Band used to do. It's a Lieber and Stoller song called Framed. And we're going to do a different version of it tonight, which is good. We're going to do a couple of things at the end, maybe
classic
Cafe Jacques songs. Some rock and roll and a few new ones, you know, to get people up on their feet. Because the Cafe Jacques stuff's a little bit prog rock. If you start dancing on your left foot, halfway through you're on your right foot and you just don't know where you're going, you know, there's a lot of tempo changes, shall we say.
Stomping back and forth.
Yes, you could say that. Yeah, you could say that.
And we should mention also that we're also joined by David, who's sitting across the table, kind of slightly quiet, but at this moment in time you can't, but I've been speaking...
Duncan, I'll let you talk to him in a minute while I have a little sip of this libation.
Oh, fair enough, Chris.
We've had some great conversation all afternoon.
We've had a fantastic time. Obviously,
you guys meeting on Monday to pick out the furniture? Is that
I was actually kind of hoping you and I'd go over that one.
I'm a Sunday afternoon man. IKEA.
IKEA too.
Yeah.
Is that a new I love you?
In Russian.
But David, you're talking about what you've done throughout your lifetime as well.
Yeah, we've been playing for ever and ever all different bands. Like, not quite up with where Chris is, but so many different bands. And asked me to come to do this with Chris Thompson, being his friend. It was an adventure, and it still is an adventure. It's like,
there was an adventure.
That's
actually, let me tell you this. About a year and a half ago, Mr. Thompson, the singer, songwriter, guitarist for the Cafe Jacques, chief cook and bottle washer, we've been friends for years and years and years. He asked me to meet him in a hotel in Glasgow for a small libation, which turned into a rather large one. And he said, I want to put Cafe Jacques back together, but I want all West Coast musicians, no Edinburgh people, apart from himself. So I got in touch with this reprobate and a fantastic keyboard player called Stewart. And we've lost a million since then. No, since then we've managed to play here last year, and we've recorded a very wonderful EP, which will be on sale tonight, called Cafe Jacques, believe it or not.
Funnily enough, is that the one that's just been pressed and all the CD cases
well,
made?
It's still sticking the labels on.
As far as I know, Chris is still sticking the labels on it. Oh no, that doesn't sound right on radio.
Nothing ever does.
Have you finished the CDs yet, Chris? Christopher?
Have you stopped licking those labels?
Would you stop licking the labels? Have you finished in the CD for tonight? It's finished. Yes. Duncan, yeah.
So it's finished.
We haven't heard it yet. Due to careful planning.
Boys,
I'll let you go back to Hoo-Ha. His name's Hoo-Ha.
Hoo-Ha Haley, I know.
Hoo-Ha. Halley. Hoo-Ha Halley. Haley's quite nice as well. It's a girl's name, you know.
Yes, I know.
When he gets a nurse's uniform on, we call him Haley. His real name's Halley.
So it's your turn for the nurse's uniform.
Yeah.
So it goes around.
As I said, it goes back. Yeah. And we've got two of us, right, so you better hurry up.
Yeah. No worries, David.
It's a bit like a library book that's going to catch out for the next day.
Yeah. Actually, my audience is used to this, so carry on, boys.
Okay. But where is your station based?
It's Haddington.
Beside Derek Dick's house. Beside Fish's house.
Yeah,
Fish.
Yeah. Well, actually, when we first started, he was one of our presenters.
Derek's a great friend of mine.
Oh, well, there you go.
I'll have to come through and see you, Duncan.
Got to pop in, especially on the classic Anthems on a Saturday.
Yeah. Maybe manage that. So are you there tomorrow?
I am. Well, actually, no, I'll be here tomorrow.
Oh, well, I'm not coming then. If you're not... Well, that sounds bad as well, doesn't it?
Is that nurse's uniform?
Is that nurse's uniform?
Could be a bit audience, of, there could be a bit of wearing it.
There could be a bit of seepage tomorrow then.
That's also...
You're taking that too far.
Oh, I'm taking it too far, right. I will come through to Haddington, I promise you, some date in the future to see Derek and yourself.
Fantastic. Now, that's something I'd love to have you guys in.
Yeah, wonderful.
Classic
Anthems. Wait a minute, does that sound right on radio?
Nothing ever
sounds
right
on
radio.
You'd love to have those guys in.
You've been listening to my Friday show as well.
I'll hail a uniform again.
Oh, we got to get a picture taken, boys. Oh, man, I'm really looking forward to tonight, honestly. And I'm looking forward to actually down the line with you coming in and having a proper sit down in the studio.
Oh, yeah, no, we can do that. Cool. We can do that. Especially since he lives locally.
Yeah. Fantastic. That'd be great. Is there anything else you'd like to say before we complete this?
Yes, set? Have you got that £5 you owe me, Duncan?
Is that the one that Ian just took from me?
Yeah, well, your fly's open.
But again!
Well, that's either a £5 note or you're pleased to see me. I'm not quite sure.
It's more like a tenner.
Whoa, can't say that on radio.
That's also cut. I think we're going to get about 30 seconds on this, guys.
Oh no, Duncan.
No, no, I'm kidding.
It's just the way you take it, and we're not like that.
No.
I mean, you've got a one-track mind, a duck track, but I mean,
no,
we're okay.
Enough, I do, and the audience also knows that as well.
I'm liking him more and more, David. What do you think? He's funny. Let's shoot him just once.
Yeah. Just once. Just on the leg, please.
Oh, okay. Hey, is that a code?
Oh. Chris, David, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you, Duncan. Our pleasure.
Thank you very much.
And which radio station?
At East Coast FM.
This is Chris Glenn saying, listen to East Coast FM because I have your address and I will be around to see you if you don't.